miracles.
Yeah.
How can God multiply? How can God answer your prayer when you cannot do it or you don't have faith to do it? So it's the faith that he has. Then he start to plant and sow and sow and sow. The Bible says that he reap the harvest of hundredfold.
Hallelujah.
See, the interest in the bank is normally 12%, 10%. But the interest in the kingdom economics is 30%, 60%,
hallelujah,
normally 100%. Hallelujah. And that is something that will boggle. No? It will challenge your mind.
Yeah, it's mind-boggling.
Because that's how God operates. Imagine the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish to feed 5,000. See? Even that we cannot fathom.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. How even as a pastor,
yes,
we cannot fathom. How science cannot explain. Counting the stars or seeing.
Yeah. I mean, you have to fly, if you have to get that 5 loaves of bread, with the pita bread and the fish, to feed the 500, physically thinking, if you have to cut it in any way, it wouldn't fit the 500.
It's a lunch for a boy.
Yeah.
So
it fed the whole
5,000. According to John, it does not say men alone. But the same story in Mark, it says 5,000 men. Yeah. So that means men normally in coming to the word of God, coming to listen, coming to church, normally it's more women and children. So you're talking about 15,000 people. Hallelujah. And 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. The Bible says they eat and they fill.
Yeah.
And
the leftover.
Leftover is 12 baskets.
Yeah. But if you put the 5 bread and the 2 fish, that cannot even fit the 12 basket. I mean, the physical sense.
It's only half basket.
Yes. And to think that God used that, fed the whole 5,000 as stated, and still can have 12 basket left.
Hallelujah.
Well, that's the mathematics that you have to really, you know, work it out in your mind.
The whole
mathematics. If God can do that, what is your problem that you're facing at home that you cannot do? Maybe mortgage, maybe your car payments, maybe you don't know which, you know, where to look and what to do, and you're really stuck with your finances. You need to do that. You need to have faith in God. And maybe we are all sitting on the edge. You don't want to really let go of your friends. You really don't want to let go of certain things of your life, like what we've been teaching all throughout the God of Foundation program every Sunday. There are little adjustments that you need to do. Check your friends, check your fellowship, check the words that you say, your daily living. You have to prepare that condition for God to be able to provide the provision into your life. It doesn't come automatically.
Yeah.
He meets you actually halfway. So you need to get rid of
such
things
conditions.
You need to bump up a little bit. You need to do something. You need to adjust your life, a little life adjustment for you to meet God halfway. So however you adjust, you just know that's not for you. And then maybe you're in the midst, you stay in a place, some people, some
gossip,
people,
and slander,
gossip,
talk about people.
Yeah, talk about people, talk about the dogs, talk about the house, talk about nearly everything. So, you need